morning, here we are on Fiumelate River, which is suffering, as all watercourses of the area, this period of water scarcity. The number and the duration of left cage drought have risen by 29% since 2000. Actually, more than 2.3 billion people have suffered from water stress in 2022. So, drought may affect over 3/4 of the world population by 2050. On the other hand, the United Nations estimated that 223 large-scale floods occurred in 2021, which is much more than the average value of 163 annual floods recorded in the previous 20 years, from 2001 to 2020. Moreover, the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change warns that extreme precipitation events are likely to intensify by about 7% for every 1 degree Celsius of global temperatures increase. If we are aware that floods and droughts are intensified by climate change, we can also understand that human behavior and action can make the difference. The challenge is to find a balance between water needs and risk in order to make cities water sustainable and resilient. But how can you do it? First, cities and urban settlements in general should integrate traditional urban drainage systems with nature-based solutions in order to foster natural processes such as interception, evapotranspiration, and infiltration, restoring the natural water cycle as much as possible. Second, advanced water supply strategies for the sustainable management of water resources must be implemented. This can be achieved, for example, through the reduction of water loss and waste, using non-conventional water resources and encouraging rainwater harvesting and reuse. These topics are fundamental for the future of the cities, I mean, for our own future and for the future of our children.